All right, it's time to start recording. Well, almost. There are a couple things you should know about making the best recording possible. First, recording your screen is a lot about patience. You're gonna make an occasional mistake, and if you do, there's probably a way to fix it. And if you can't fix it, it's relatively easy to re-record. Take your time and you'll be fine. As you start your recording, make sure your recording size is set and that the area selected is correct. If you're not sure or want to check how it will look, make a sample recording. If the size is right, push record and off you go. Now let's look at a few final tips to help you make a better recording. As you start recording, capture what you can in one take or until you make a mistake. When you make a mistake, it's a good time to pause or stop the recording. The benefit of pausing is that it keeps it intact as one video, and you can restart when you're ready to begin again. Since you won't want to leave the mistake in your video, you'll need to take one or two steps back in your process, or to a natural place to restart, and start recording with those steps. When you edit your recording, you'll cut out the mistake and piece together the best parts. As you record, whether you're recording audio at the same time as a video or separately, it can be helpful to have a list of steps printed or on another screen so you know exactly what you need to record. It's easy to skip steps or rush once you start, even if you know the process well. This will help you avoid mistakes and keep you from missing anything important. Next, let's look at tips for your mouse cursor during recording. Your cursor is a key element on your screen. It provides information to the viewer about where to look and if you've taken any actions, like clicking a button. As you move your cursor, each movement should be deliberate and have purpose. Avoid the temptation to use it as a laser pointer. There are better ways to highlight and emphasize what you're talking about. When you're moving your cursor to take an action, like clicking a link or a button, you'll want to first move it near where you'll click. And before you take the action, build in a short pause, just a second or less, so that the viewer can anticipate the action you're going to take. If you're moving your cursor but aren't going to take an action, move it to the side of whatever you're talking about. You'll want to avoid having your cursor jump all over the screen as you edit together different clips. Do the best you can to keep it located in approximately the same location between different recordings. Some programs will help you do this when you pause the recording. Otherwise, you'll either need to mark the spot on the screen, a sticky note works well for this, or just try to get it as close as possible. When typing text, you'll also want to be aware of the cursor's location. Make sure it doesn't cover the text input box. Simply move it to the left or right of where you're typing. If you have a lot of text to add, you may want to create a text document that contains all the text you'll need to add during the recording. Instead of typing everything out, you can cut and paste the information to any text fields. As we wrap up screen recording, remember, take your time. Unless your audience has expertise on what you're sharing, you'll want to go at a pace that will be easy for them to follow along. Going too quickly will make it hard to watch your video and make it more likely that your viewer has to spend more time watching and re-watching to understand your content. Next up, let's take a quick look at capturing presentation software like PowerPoint.